Hello guys, so today I want us to go through how to set up PPPoE for our clients. That is the router at the client's end, that is the CPE. And basically what we need to do first, before that, we need to ensure that our core router, which is our MikroTik, is also connected to the internet and it's able to access the internet. So this is a situation where your ISP has provided you internet and has just told you to set up DHCP client on your router so that you can be connected to the internet. So let's go through that. You can see that this router has already been reset. It has no configuration. We can test if it has internet first. Yeah, and you can see that we have no internet connection on this router. So for us to have internet connection here, all we need to do is set up a DHCP client. So all we need to do is come to IP. We're going to leave that ping running, then DHCP client. Then we're going to add the DHCP client. We want it to go to Ether 1 because that's where the cable that's been provided to us is going to. So you need also to leave this checked, use peer DNS, use peer NTP. So the NTP is just basically to sync the time and all that. So we are going to apply. Okay, so I think we should now be having internet connection. If we close this, you can now see we are able to have internet connection. Let's stop this. Maybe we can also ping this so that we see if the DNS is being resolved well. Yes, it is. So we are going to stop that as well. So basically our core router is now connected to the internet. So the router itself has five ports. And the first port is where your internet is coming in through. So we want to have a situation whereby the remaining four ports are able to give internet to your end clients. So what we need to do first is we need to bridge the remaining ports. So we are going to create a bridge, come to bridge, and then say add. We are just going to leave the name as bridge one. Apply. Okay, so after that we now need to specify the ports that we need to be on that bridge. So we come to ports, then say add. We want interface, that is interface 2, to be on that bridge. Then apply, copy 3. Just a minute, I think we lost that connection. Yeah, we are back. 3, apply, copy, 4, apply, copy, and the last one, 5, apply, copy. Oh, just a minute, 2 didn't come on. So we are going to add 2 as well. Apply, okay. So as it is, you can see that we have bridged all the ports there. We are going to reconnect again. So we are going to close that. So what we now need to do is we need to assign an IP address to that bridge, because that is now going to be the gateway that your clients are going to connect to. So we need to come to IP address, we say add. Maybe let's give it 172.16.0.1. This is going to be /24, and we need it to be on bridge 1. Apply. Okay, so as it is, basically this router is now able to give internet connection to the routers that will be connected to it, be it TP-Link, tender, or if you have another MikroTik router. And before we do that, we also need to set up an IP pool where these clients will be pulling their IPs from. So we need to come to IP, then IP pool, then we now want to create a pool. We are going to leave it just as pool 1. Maybe we are going to say this to be 10.10.20.2 to 10.10.20.254. Apply. Okay. So basically, this is the IP range that your clients are going to get. So, and this IP does not, when it goes to the internet, it doesn't get internet connection. So for this IP to be able to have internet connection, what we now need to do to it is we need to NAT this IP, that is a network address translation. So we need to come to IP, scroll down to firewall, then you come to NAT, then you say add general. So that's the source NAT, and our address, the IP that we need to NAT is 10.10.20.0/24. We want to NAT the whole range. Then you come to action, and the action here is going to be masquerade. You apply that. Okay. So when this IP is assigned to your clients, they are definitely going to be able to receive internet connection. So now we are done with that. We now need to set up PPPoE for our clients. So the next step that follows is you come to PPP. That's right here. Then we need to have our profiles here. So we come to profiles and then say add. So we are going to name this as profile 1. And our local address is going to be 10.10.20.1. That's going to be the gateway. And our remote address is going to be pool 1. We also need to put in a DNS server here, which is going to be assigned to the client's end. Then you need to just apply. Okay. The next step that follows is now we need to have secrets. Secrets, this is now where we are going to input our PPPoE username and PPPoE passwords. So you say add. So let's say this client is going to be, let's say, new, let's have it as one word, new client. And the password, this is now the PPPoE password. This is going to be, let's use 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the service that we want is PPPoE. And the profile that we want is profile 1. You remember we had created that profile. So we are going to apply. Okay, so basically that is how you add your PPPoE clients. So this is going to be your first client. Then after that, we now need to go to the PPPoE servers. You also click on add, and then we pick the interface, which is going to be the bridge. And then we are also going to pick the profile, default profile, which is going to be profile 1, the same profile we created. We are going to do one session per host, then click on apply and okay. Another thing that I wanted, that I forgot to mention, is that when you are creating the profiles, there's also limits that you are able to set for your clients. So let's say you want maybe the client to be assigned 5 Mbps. So you need to set that from the profile. So you come to profiles, limits, then rate limits. So maybe we are going to set this as 5 Mbps up and 5 Mbps down. Yeah, just that. Apply. Okay. So basically, when this client connects to is able to authenticate, when you come to queues, you are also going to be able to see the upload and download that this client has been assigned, and that upload and download is going to be 5 Mbps, which we created for this particular profile. So we are done doing that. So the next thing that we need to do now is to log into the client's router, which we now need to input the PPPoE username and the PPPoE password. So for us to get into the client's router, I have a tender router with me here. So let me just get it hooked up with my machine so that we can log into it and set it up. Yeah, that's why we are thrown out. And yep, that's it. Just that's usually the default IP to log into your tender router. So what we need to do is set up the PPPoE username. We said it was the name was new client, and the password that we set was 12345. Yeah, and maybe we are going to name this as Mr. Wisp 254. We are going to leave it the password open. Then we are going to click on OK. It's that simple. So now we need to plug in the WAN cable. Just a minute as I do that. Yeah, it's now plugged in. And within a minute, we should now be able to see that our tender router has now been connected to the internet. Let's just refresh this. No, we need to connect to the Wi-Fi that we created. That is that. Connect. It's connected. Yeah, you can see we even now have two devices attached to it. So this router has already been given its IP. It's already been given its you can see that the PPPoE that we did set up is now connected. The status is you can surf the internet, and you can see that it has all the details that we did provide. It has been assigned an IP from the pool that we created. It has a subnet mask. It has a gateway. You remember we created this gateway on our MikroTik router. You remember we also created this DNS. So if we also come back to our MikroTik router, we need to reconnect back to this. So when you come to PPP, then you come to active connections, you're going to be able to see that this client has already been authenticated. He's been given an IP address. He has an uptime of 1 minute and 40 seconds. And when you also come to queues, you're also going to be able to see this same client. Let's just have this expanded. New client. And you can see that the upload and the download that we set 5. And another thing that probably you can set to your MikroTik routers to see if this client is pulling any traffic, you just need to come to this, click on show columns, and we can maybe scroll down. Yep, we are going to pick download, we are going to pick upload, then we are going to say okay. So you can be able to see that there's traffic running on that router. So that's it for today. Remember to like this video, subscribe. I'm going to be doing more tutorials on MikroTik and Ubiquiti networks. And be sure that to leave a comment down below to tell me what you think of my videos, what you think I should talk about or handle next. And thanks for your time.